This is another video in my series where I'm trying to establish a troubleshooting flowchart for air conditioning systems that don't seem to be running right. So the customer tells you that the inside air handler seems to be blowing air, just not cold air. But they also tell you that the AC outside is running. So what could it be? Let's go through some checks to get you in a better place. Without making this a long drawn out process, I'm going to assume that you have the basic electrical troubleshooting skills and a multimeter with an amp clamp with some temperature probes and get right to the flow chart that I've created. And we're also going to assume that this is a single stage AC. Two stage and variable speed systems are similar to single stage, but a little different. Fair warning, it's really easy to get electrocuted troubleshooting. If you don't have the right skills for this, call a technician who does. Also, I like to tell the customer that I will find and fix the first problem I see. Once I fix it, I'll run the system again to see if anything else in the sequence of operation is not running right. It's just a nice caveat to mention so that they don't think that you're trying to rip them off. Okay, the indoor air handler is blowing air, albeit room temperature air, and you're told that the condenser outside is running. I always start by checking the filters to see if they're clean, no matter where they are, including the attic if it's there. I'm usually not antsy to head into the attic on hot summer days, but sometimes it's like a 4-inch media filter at the furnace in the attic, and if it's caked, that'll solve a lot of problems. Because a lot of times on a service call, you get to the house and see a perfectly clean filter. So I like to acknowledge the customer in a positive way for changing their air filter and remind them that it's the single most important thing that they can do to keep your system clean and running for many years. At the same time, I also want to know when they changed it and how dirty it was before replacing it yesterday. Because how many times have you gotten to the house and the customer says, "I just changed the filter yesterday." Anyways, heading outside, from first glance, are the condenser coils clean? Honestly, dirty filters and dirty coils are related to about half of your problems with AC units that aren't cooling enough. If you find that the condenser fan is running, but the compressor at the bottom of the unit is not running, click over here to check out how I troubleshoot an AC when the condenser fan is running, but the compressor isn't. But if the compressor is running, make sure that you have matching sized evaporator and condensing coils. If you don't, install matching coils. Because everything relies on a balance of refrigerant and airflow across these coils, and it starts with having the right equipment. Next, let's make sure that you have the 300 to 400 CFMs of air going across that evap coil. If you don't, then check the return duct to make sure that it's sized right and it's not crushed. Also, check the airflow chart in the book because it'll give you some details as to where the dip switches or speed taps need to be to achieve proper CFMs of airflow. Let's say you do have proper airflow across the coil. Now, check to see if you have a TXV or a fixed orifice metering device at the evaporator coil. Is it a fixed orifice? Is it the right size? If it's not, install the correct size orifice. Yes, the orifice is already the right size. Then, is the superheat higher or lower than the required superheat for that setup? It's too high? Then charge it up to specs. If the superheat is too low, then you'll need to recover some charge and get it dialed in just right. Or was the metering device a TXV? Is it the right size and is it designed for the same refrigerant in your system? Let it run for a few minutes. Your gauges could be doing a myriad of things right now, depending on whether the TXV is stuck open, hunting, or partially stuck closed. So let's get into faulty TXVs in another video, and I'll try to link it to the end of this video so that you can easily switch over to it in a minute. Let's check some of the basic fundamentals though before we start throwing more refrigerant into the system. Are the air filters clean? Are there more than one? Are the condenser coils clean? Is the evaporator coil clean? Is the blower assembly clean? If it's a condensing furnace, is the secondary heat exchanger clean? It might sound weird, but has the condenser fan blade been changed since the original install? Is it still the right size, removing heat efficiently? Check the refrigerant charge. I have a video on how I add refrigerant to an AC system, but as a reminder, measuring your subcool and superheat with your gauges and some temperature sensors is the correct way to determine whether you have the right amount of refrigerant in the system, it's not necessarily beer can cold all the time. Is there a restriction in the refrigerant lines in the form of a kink somewhere in the line set that runs between the outdoor unit and the indoor unit? Another restriction could be at the filter dryer. Is there more than a 2 to 3 degree difference between one side of the liquid line filter dryer and the other? If the refrigerant charge is correct and you're still not getting sufficient cooling, check the size of the unit itself, especially if there's been any remodeling, add-ons, or major changes to the home. That affects the load on the house and could mean that the system is too small now. I've serviced a lot of those massive pre-planned communities that were all built like an assembly line, and the HVAC contractor who won the job for that huge project may have miscalculated the size that it needed to be. If the unit is not large enough to overcome the heat load put on the house, the system will just run all day and never get the house cool. Check the home's insulation levels and keep it in mind when determining your conclusion. If there seems to be a problem with one room not getting enough air, then there's likely a problem with the duct system or its design. Maybe adding a larger duct to that south-facing room will deliver the right amount of air. That might also mean enlarging the C-box and the supply register in that room, but not every time. Are any of the ducts crushed, especially the return duct? Maybe the supply duct is in a poor spot on the supply plenum, so it's an afterthought for the air entering the supply plenum. The air hitting the back of the supply plenum will always get the most advantageous airflow. And then last, is the duct that's supplying that room attached to a TY? Is the Y built correctly? Does it split off at a 35 to 45 degree angle, not like a real T and a sharp 90? KD pipe with a hard 90 won't allow the air to divert towards the duct. It'll take the path of least resistance, so make sure you have a good TY connection. All right, so we often get to this point where it must be the TXV. So check out my video on how to diagnose a bad TXV. There's a lot to consider when going down that road, but I promise that I can get you through it. If this is your first time watching our channel, please click subscribe down here on the bottom right. And if you click that little bell next to it, you'll be notified of all of our videos as they come out. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.
You're watching Fox Family Heating and Air. Don't forget to subscribe. And check out more of our videos by clicking on the right side of the screen.